You see, that's what Philip says, first one, the ring. I would rather see. Please, you know, pi I pi, 4 pi I minus 4 pi I, the equality looks. It's pi I minus pi I. If you are rounding this side, you will solve the contours. Now, let's see, what do we do first? Do I rush straight to substitute or do we draw the region? We draw the region and check which ones constitute the value of the integral. The ones that are within our what? On the boundary. Okay, now let's draw it. So, what is our region? Second set of the origin of radius what? 3. 3, 3i, minus 3i, negative 3. Clear? How many similarities do we have there?
2.
Which one? The first one is what? At 1. Because if I like by solver, every integral like by solver is at 1. 1 is somewhere there, because you can tell 3, 1, 2. Then 1, 2. Clear? Then the first one is at what? 1. Maybe I'm staring. Are we together? Another similarity is what?
Minus
2. Why are we saying that the minus 3 is a similarity? Because that minus 3, the function is undefined. It's also not analytic. As long as the function is not defined there or it's not differentiable there, then the point is a similarity. Then, but this one approaches only those that are within. Now let's see, the other one is what now?
Minus
2. 2 or minus 2?
Minus 2.
Minus 2. It's undefined at minus 2. Then we are here. Then we can put the step there. Are they both within?
Yeah.
We are still being choose by path. They are equally important to the value of the integral. Meta cleaning. We clean against the right? Yeah, we clean everything. Now we are going to first use what partial fractions. But we have to be careful how we apply them. In first year, they will say you copy everything as it is. Or multiply, then we go to the whole numerate. Here we are doing a where there is a simple alteration, right? Yeah, we're changing something a bit. Always partial fractions, we apply with the numerator one. Partial fractions, you apply them with the numerator the 1. Partial fractions is both within, or all of them within. Now this is 1 over z minus 1, over z plus 2, but this is a lie, because I'm changing the overall functions. But it can be true if what? It can be what? If our later multiplied by the what? The numerator. So it means I can just do by path the 1, then later distribute the numerator. It will be the same use. You just do by path the 1, always the later distribute the what? I don't know you are advanced. But if you say you will copy the numerators, it is white or multiplier, 1, 1, 1, 1, patiently, then white or equal to 1. But here, no. You just do it the one later, just to put the numerator. Okay, here. So let's see. This is now a over what? The first one being z minus 1, right? Plus b, equally important. Both within. Even if one was on top. Then b over what? This side is z plus 2. Clear? Which implies, let's equate the numerators. This will be what's in the a z plus 2a, right? R the gamma here. Then it's plus bz what? Bz minus a?
Minus b.
Minus b. Is equals to what is the numerator?
1.
But now go back to first level. We are going to equate to z cube minus z. What? Our just z of an equation of 3. So what are the equation of 1? Here we are not doing that. Always the 1. We later distribute the numerator. Then what is the numerator here? Always 1. Don't forget to later distribute, right?
But are you saying that thing is equal to this?
That's why I said this is, you see, like we are changing, but don't worry, because if I say 1 over, then I multiply by the numerator, will be right. So we do it by 1. There's no two fractions that are distributed, the numerator, to really go back there. Are we together? Are we telling people? Yeah, something like that. Just break it down and the laser distribute. I know that this is a bit, it seems like now we built it to 1, but the numerator of that. Don't worry about this, because we are still going to what? Distribute. Because if I were to break it, then I say z cube plus 1 over, I didn't change that. Then it means now I can that z cube multiplies this and multiplies that. Capacial fractions. That's why we get a 1, then from later I distribute. Okay, now let's see. Now which means now there are maybe two equations, right? Constant is 2a minus b equals to 1. Clear?
Yeah.
I'm having 2a minus b is equals to
1.
What is b? This implies that b is equals to what will be 2a minus 1, right?
Mm.
2a minus 1, this can be the first equation. Clear?
Mm.
I report a variable. Variable in a z plus bz equals to 0z.
Mm-hmm.
Coefficient z on the left side is 0. then you will have A plus B is equals to what?
Zero.
This equation what?
Two.
Okay, A plus B equals to what? We have the definition of A, right? Substitute 1 into 2. This will follow, right? A plus 1 is B. 2A minus 1 equals 2. That's what 2 says, right? So this further you press, what is A plus 2A? 3A minus 1 equals to 0, right? This 3A equals to 1, right? Which leads to A being what? Okay. But we have a function that leads A and B, right? This will later imply that B is equals to 2 into 1. What is A? 1 over 3 minus 1. We go back to the subject. B to A minus 1. No matter what value of A is, B equals to 2A minus 1. So this would be what? 2 over 3 minus 1 is 1. 3 over 3, right? LCD, what do we get?
Minus 1 over 3.
Now it's breakable, right? Partial fractions, they are equally important to the value of the integral. If within or on the boundary, are we clear, one?
Yeah.
Okay, so now this means now in the solution, I'm going to say the integral along which path? Z equals to 3. What is the numerator? Z plus 3, Z minus
1.
All over, what are the similarities? Z minus 8.
Z plus 2.
Into Z plus 2. D what? Is equals to. Now remember, always remember, we threw away the numerator, now we bring it back. We are distributing. Because to really get the same D. Now I have to multiply this with 1, then it brings me back there. Which is the same as having that numerator, distributing it on the two fractions. Really, this is the case we distribute. Now the first one, our A is 1 over 3, right? It's 1 over 3, but times the numerator now gets, it must come back. What is the numerator? Because it's 1 here. Once I 1 over 3, so we can touch another 1. But the numerator is distributing. To bring it back, is Z cubed plus what? 3Z minus 1. Are we clear?
Mm.
Over first part I'm writing
Z
minus 1 dz. Are we together? Mm. Then we are writing negative 1 over 3. Any integral 1, yes, we'll put 1 here, but we later distribute the numerator.
Mm.
You can do partial fraction somewhere. Then from there, write this equal to part, breaking the 2. Then minus 1 over 3, then the same half 3. Then we have what? The whole function is Z cubed plus 1. 3z minus 1 because we are distributing. Then the similarity is z plus what?
Mm.
Z plus 2d
dz.
Then you apply i1, i2. You can let that be i1, let that one be i2. Then dd 2 pi ifa, 2 pi ifa. Then let the 2. Is it clear?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, just this is integral alone. Remember, what is f of z on the first one? On the first, if this was i1, what is the f of z? Z cubed plus 3z minus 1. Are we clear?
Mm.
Then what is the similarity? A equals to 1, right?
Mm.
Now the question is, what is f at 1? After the break even, would you have a path or the end? Then f at 1 will go by 1 cubed plus 3z, 1 minus 1 each. So shall I 3 into 1, the problem which is? Because wherever this is that you put 1.
Mm.
Are we clear, break? But this whole thing is the same as what? Is the same as the function value times 2 pi r. So, which means the overall integral, which is this equal to that, is now equal to. Remember, I'm going to have the function value, which is what? What is the function value? Same thing. 3 times 2 pi I, right? But I'm dividing the overall. Because this is the value of that. By question integral, for only this is 2 pi I times f at a. Then 2 pi I times f at a, now dividing by 3, you also divide this by what?
By 3.
Then we do the same here. This minus, right?
Mm.
The function value here. Now, what is our donor? Our f of z is still the same. This is i2 now, right?
Mm.
F of z, you just take the extract the numerator. The numerator is what?
Z cubed plus 3z minus 1.
Are we here?
Mm.
We are at 1. What is the value of a? What is our similarity?
Yes.
Negative 2. Because it's z minus minus.
Mm.
The original integral formula says minus. Then it means now I want f at 1 now. What is my a now?
Negative 2.
Which leads to negative 8. Are we together?
Mm-hmm.
Negative 2 cubed is negative 8. Plus 3 times negative 2? Minus 6. Are we together?
Mm-hmm.
Minus 6 minus 1. Minus 8 minus 14, right? Minus 14 minus 1? Negative 15. What is the function value here? The function value, this is plus, the function value is negative 15. Are we here? The function value is negative 15 multiplied by what now?
2 pi.
2 pi I. But what must happen now? We must divide by what? Minus. By minus 3. We must divide by minus 3. So we divide by negative 3. Now the question was both sides of negative 3. This integer minus 15 times 2 pi I is only this integral. Where is it? Without the 1 over 3. Only this. 2 pi I times f of a. F at a we know is minus 15. We extract f, then we extract a. Put a in f, because it's f at a equals 2. The notion of a, 2 pi I times f at a is the integral. But the integral divides 3, negative 3. Then you also divide by what? By minus 3. And I'm like, that's I1, I2. This is now 3 and 3. You can just simplify, right? We're going to be left with what? 2 pi r. Now, 3 is negative 3 or negative 15. Yeah, positive 5, right? Positive 5 times 2 pi I, 10 pi what? Then what is 2 pi I plus 12? 10 pi I. And that's the original value of the integral. I don't know how you can break it if you don't understand. On a not f at a 2 pi I, you can't see it explicitly. Just say a1 is. Or evaluate by there. Then our I2 is. Or evaluate. If it's divide 3, you also divide by 3. It divides minus 3, you divide by minus 3 that side. The function value times 2 pi I. You divide by whatever the integral is divided. Because only this numerator is there, is that integral. The numerator is this. So if it's divide 3, you divide by 3. If it's divide minus 3, you divide by minus 3. Do you have another games? Then you do a simplification. Here is 5, 5 times 2, 10, 10 plus 2. Then you have 2 pi I. And is it understandable?
Yeah.
Do we now know when to use by path?
Yeah.
No, not by path. Partial fractions, right? Partial fractions. If both